Here's a demo of the grocer application. I'm going to walk you through the customer application placing an order to the store and the store receiving an order and processing it and pushing it out to the driver application, who then delivers the order and completes the whole order cycle. So on the customer application, the first thing that we see on the top is the delivery location, because the whole product set that is visible to a customer and the store set that is visible to a customer based on his location. The location could be taken from the customer's GPS, that is his current location, or could be one of the saved addresses from his account, or we could finally add a specific location to move the customer to that physical location. So for example, we're going to move on to Kormangla, which is a different place, about 17 kilometers away from here. So when I do that, I move to a different store. As we can see, it's called the spa store. But if I go back and click on my current location, I'm back to the Big Bazaar map. If I go ahead and click on the selected store, it gives me information about the other stores that are available here, and I could move on to them. There's a little information about the stores available, which says how far is the store from the current location of the customer, what are the store ratings that have been provided based on the customers have already ordered from them, and what is the estimated time for an order to reach from the store to the customer. And this can all be set in the backend, except for the rating and the miles, as this is calculated in real time. As we go back, the first thing that we see on the top right after the selected store is a set of offers that are available. So every store could create its own offers and give discounts to customers on products, categories, or the entire inventory. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Monsoon Savers and see that there are products which are listed with the details, mainly the prices cut out to show the discounted prices. So this is very evident for any customer who is using what is the exact price and what is the kind of discount he's trying to get when he opts for this offer. So when I go back, I can see one of the intelligence systems, which is called as the trending products. This module is written in Python and also runs on a basic algorithm that is very intelligent, and at the same time gives the customer an experience of the trending products that are available around him. The algorithm is completely based on users' actions in a particular area on different products. The actions would include adding a product to the cart, adding a product to the wish list, favoriting a product, checking out a product, by which I mean purchasing a product and having it in the final sale of order that you place with the application. I could go ahead and click on one of the products and see the details. We're going to come back to the details of the product later. Then we've got everyday lowest prices, which talk about the lowest prices of the store for the day, which helps the customer not only buy more, but also induces the concept of looking towards offers, and hence this would increase the sales of the store. Favorites are something specific to the user, which means that all the favorite items that have been marked as favored by the customers are going to show on the home page. So it decreases the hassle of going through the menu on the application, and finally reducing the time for the sale of the order. Going down, based on the similar algorithm as the trending products, we've got the trending brands or the top brands. When I go ahead and click on Mirinda, I can see the product under Mirinda. If I go ahead and click on Real, I can see there are two kinds of products that are available under the Real brands. This helps in grouping the products better, and people associate with the brands. This helps people to buy more from the same brand when they trust a specific brand. Right after that, we've got different categories that are available for the store, and each category could have its own subcategory. And these are all populated from the CMS panel and are updated in real time, which means that every time you make a change, it's going to reflect for all the customers here on the store. Before we jump into one of the cash subcategories, I'm going to show you what's on the base or the tab bar of the application. Here we've got the home page, which we are at right now. Then we've got the search section, where I could search for a specific product. And this search is powered by Elasticsearch, which is a super fast search database that allows the search results to be populated under a second. So I'm going to go ahead and look for Oreo, and I can see there are suggestions being made. But if I remove all my entered items, I can see there are certain popular searches which are again based on the customers trying to search in this area, and it gives us more suggestions about what people are buying and inducing the whole concept inside the sales cycle for a customer, so the customer can buy more. So I'm going to go ahead and search for Nabisco, which is a brand of the biscuits that are available. When I click on search, I can see that different products from the Nabisco brand are available here, and Oreo are available here. I could also go ahead and click on filter. That will make it more easier for me to look at if we have long list of products. So we could filter them based on prices, categories, brands, manufacturers, offers, and sort them with the popular ones on the top, the newest ones on the top, or arrange them based on the prices, low to high and high to low. Going back to the home page, I'm going to go ahead and click on one of the products. The product details are available here, and we've got a lot of product details available for a single product that could all be entered from the CMS panel. We could have multiple pictures available for a product. I could favorite a product. I could add a product to a wish list, which is more like creating your own list of products that you can always go back to and sort and directly place an order. So I've got a Sunday shopping list. I could create a Monday shopping list and add it. And I can add this particular product to the Monday shopping list. So when I go back to the Monday shopping list, I'm going to find my Oreo Thins there. We've got the price of the product, a description, ingredients, and various nutritional facts that can all be entered from the CMS panel. Right after that, we've got different units of the product available, which is 20 grams and 40 grams. So if I go back and click on 40 grams here, I can see the price under the biscuit and cookies changes to 80 rupees. And if I go back to 20, it changes back to 40. So we can have n number of units, and each of them will have a different price available that can be changed based on this. So I'm going to go ahead and increase the quantity of 20 grams of Oreos, and I'm going to have 6 of them and add them to the cart. So that brings me to this third section of the third tab on the tab bar at the bottom, which is the cart page. On the cart page, I can see I have just one store, which is Big Bazaar North, and I am 360 rupees away from free delivery from this store, and there's 6 of Nabisco Oreo Thins, golden sandwich cookies that are available. Now, I could have multiple stores, orders being placed for multiple stores. So the cart supports a marketplace model. So let's go to a different store, see Family Supermart. I'm going to go ahead and order a Maza mango fruit drink here and add this to the cart. When I go down to the cart again, now I can see that I have two different stores available in the same cart that gives a better experience for the customer if he wishes to place an order for multiple orders in turn of a marketplace. So when I do that, I can place an order to Family Supermarket and Big Bazaar North. We're going to go with the Big Bazaar store when we follow up on our workflow here. So before we head on placing an order, I would like to go over the history page. The history page shows me the active and the past orders that have been available for the customer. Active orders are the ones that are currently being placed but have not been completed, but the past orders are the ones that have been completed, rejected, or cancelled by the customer, driver, or the store. If you go back to the profile section, you can see that I have logged in by my name and username. And we've got several options available in the profile section. The first one is manage addresses. This allows you to save addresses, killing all the kind of hassles that would happen while you're creating an order. So you would not have to go again and again, create a new address or put in a new address or find a new address every time you place an order. You can simply add a new address here and create this more as a directory of saved addresses. I'm going to choose work. And finally, I can see it has been added here. So when I place an order, I'm going to choose this as an address to go ahead and place an order so that I do not have to add it again. So for n number, 20, 30, 40, unlimited number of orders, you can always choose from the save addresses or add a new address at any point of time. The second option after manage addresses is wallet and credit cards, which are the different payments options available. When I go ahead and click on wallet, this marks the virtual currency of the application. So the Grocer application comes with a Grocer wallet or Grocer money. That could be a real conversion of actual money, So right now I have a balance which is available under current cash balance. I could top up my wallet with one of these cards that are available. The card option is enabled by Stripe, but we can always integrate any other payment gateway from any country. So we can also add money. We could also see our transactions that have happened in the past. So I can see there are two transactions of debits and there are two transactions of credits. The wallet was recharged, and in debits, the wallet was exhausted by the orders that have been placed. Going back, I've got credit and debit cards, where this is enabled by Stripe that comes on the house, but you can always choose for a different payment gateway, and we can integrate that. Add new card. I'm going to go ahead and add a new card here and see if it gets added. So now I'm going to see one more card added to the list of cards. So I have a test card which ends with 4242 from Stripe being added here. I'm going to go back and see in favorites. In favorites, we have not favorited any item. So I'm going to go ahead and favorite one item for this selected store. When I do that and I go back to favorites, I can find my favorited product, which is mango maza fruit drink. We created a wish list for the other store, so not for this store, so you could have a wish list for every single store. So I'm going to go ahead and change the store back to the other list, other store, and see if we can still see our wish list. So let's go back, go to the wishlist section. Yes, we can see our wishlist. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Monday shopping list. And this is the Nabisco Oyo Thins Golden Sandwich Cookies that we added to our shopping list. So we have it so far. We've got offers here, which is a consolidated list of all the offers that were shown on the home screen. Now I can go ahead and click on one of the offers and see the products under all these offers populated properly here. When I go back, I can click on FAQs, which are most requested questions and answers given to them by the app that lets the customer use it in a better manner. When I go back, I can click on Refer Friends as well. Refer Friends allows you to share your referral code with people who would want to sign up on the application. And when they do sign up with your referral code on the application, both of you get benefits, which could be either wallet credits or coupon codes that ultimately turn out to be discounts for the orders that you place on the application. On help and support, we've got integration for Zendesk that allows you to create tickets, and the tickets go onto the Zendesk interface for customers and the application owners. The application owners can then respond to the tickets and understand people's problems or grievances and resolve them and finally reflect them here or also chat with them. We support multiple languages and also RTL that allows us to change the entire interface and support RTL here. I'm going to go ahead and place the order now. I can choose between pickup or delivery. When I click on delivery, the first step that happens is that it would ask me when do I want to get my order, which is either now or scheduled. Scheduled would be placing an order for a specific date, which is not right now and today. And now is an immediate placement of order, and you would like to receive the order as soon as possible. And the delivery location, the addresses that we had saved, we could choose one of them as our delivery location, and this would create a delivery charge that could be seen in the payment breakdown. So the third last section says delivery charge is 294.41 rupees. I'm going to go ahead and choose wallet as my payment option, click on pay, and place the order. When I place the order, I get the notification from the grocery store application, which is again running on the same system, on the same device. I'm going to go ahead and click on it and see order, a new order has order, popped up order, from Shiv.
Order,
I'm going to go ahead order, and click on it
order, order,
and accept
order,
it.
Order, order.
The moment I accept it, the customer application on the top gets a notification about it. The section of the store app that we see right now is
order,
the new section.
Order, order,
so we got a new order,
order
that we've
order,
received from
order,
another customer.
Order.
So I'm going to go ahead and
order,
accept that order or let it be here. So every order that is accepted goes on to the accepted section of the order. And I can go ahead and click on the order and see the details of the order. I can see the customer details right on the top and the number of orders I've received from Shiv so far and the revenue that we've generated from him based on the completed orders. Then we've got the payment type, the order type, and the time of the order that has occurred. Then we've got delivered to section, and then basically the items that are available. We could also edit the quantity and the price to reflect it accordingly on the customer application as well. Now we've got multiple options available at the bottom, which are assign an order to a specific driver, dispatch an order to the pool of drivers where the dispatcher itself finds the nearest driver and assigns the order. So I'm gonna see if I have a driver available for this specific store. Yes, I do. I have a James Colby available and online for this store. So when I go ahead and dispatch the order, it goes out to the driver application. On the driver application, I'm presented with all the information about the order, with the distance, payment, booking ID, pickup, drop location, the time that is left for me to accept it, and delivery fee. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it and see that the customer gets a notification that I have been assigned the order and I as a driver can be contacted on this number. The driver can see the list of orders that he has on his home screen and also a map that allows him to see his current location. Right on the top, he's got a button that allows him to go online and offline. On the left-hand side, we've got his profile, home, history, and support page. The history page tells him what all orders he's completed or can't have been cancelled or rejected by the customer or cancelled by the customer. All of them are recorded in one place. So I'm going to quickly go ahead, click on the order that we just received. And I can see all the details of the customer, the store, the delivery location, the payment method, what are the items that I got to pick up. And I can also chat with the customer, but I'm going to go ahead and start the job. I can see the details. The customer gets all the notifications for the activities of a driver. I can see the call button that allows me to call the customer directly. I can also see the details here. It allows me to see the details of the order that I'm trying to deliver right now as a driver. I could say arrive. When I say arrive, the customer gets a notification that I'm at the store. And a great thing about the application is that I can process multiple orders at the same time, meaning that while I have one of the orders with the status driver is at the store, I have another one which has been accepted by me, and I could start that one as well. We also have a Google Maps integration that allows the driver to find his way to the customer location. So I can click on the arrow at the bottom in between and it would take me to the Google Maps. I'm going to head back to my original order and say that I have arrived at the customer location. I could go back to the customer app and see the order being populated here. So I can click on track order that shows me the two location, the two pinpoints are the customer and the store location. And I can see since the customer arrived at the delivery location, I can see a car that represents the driver. So when the driver moves around, the car also moves around, which gives a very clear indication to the customer where the driver is at. Meaning that the customer can track the driver in real time as he moves around the city and gets the delivery done to him. We've got several orders available in the history tab, and for each of these orders we have different statuses. So now the driver is at the store and he's already picked up and he's at the delivery location for us. So for this order that we're looking at right now, this is a different order, but I'm gonna go ahead and say pigment starter. I'll go back to the original one. I'm going to say I've arrived at the delivery location. I see all the details here. I can also make a call to the customer to ask him to come to the door or ask him the directions if it is internally present somewhere in a society or in a building that he could guide me through. So that is really helpful. And I could also chat with him right on the top, which is available here. I could send the bill, the notifications if I would want to ask him a couple of questions like where is your door, how do I come around, is there a dog, etc, etc. So I could also see all the other details and go ahead and click on delivered. I can put a signature here and submit the order. So after the submitting the order, I can go back to the customer app, go on to the home screen, and see in the list of past orders that we've got all the completed orders available here. Let's go ahead and complete this order as well. So I get the notification for this one. I'll go ahead and say submit. The moment I do that, it says completed delivery. The earlier order that we got on the driver application incomplete, it was from a different customer, so we did not get the notification, but for this one we did, because this belongs to the customer that is on the application right now. And as soon as the last order is completed for the customer also gets a review pop-up where he can see the details of the amount that he's paid, the travel destination and the pickup location, which is mainly the store, and then finally different kinds of experience parameters that could be used by the store to upgrade or improvise the whole processes and the delivery methodologies or the experience that they give out to the customers. So all this can be configured from the back end, and you could add different options here, rating the whole experience on different parameters, and finally submit the order. This is how the entire order cycle is completed. You could repeat the similar process for pickup as well. So I'm going to go ahead and add a couple of products here. Go back to my cart, choose pickup order at this point of time, select the payment as one of the cards this time. Go ahead and place the order. When I do that, the grocer store opens up and tells me that I have a new order from Shiv. I can accept the order. I get notifications on the customer application. I'm going to go back to the accepted tab, click on the order again, say ready. This gives the customer a notification that the order is ready and he can come and pick it up. And finally, I can say the order has been picked up by the customer when the customer actually comes and picks it up, and say completed. The moment I complete the order and I go back on the customer, I can see that the order has been completed in the past orders. So that's about it. This is the entire order cycle of the Grocer application. I've walked you through how a customer places an order, to sending it out to a store, and the store finally pushing out to a driver, and the order cycle being completed by the driver delivering the order to the customer. Thank you.